Hello students, I am Dr. R.V. Chittukuppi from Classic IAS and KS Study Circle, Dharwad. I welcome all the UPSC aspirants for the Classic Education YouTube for the discussion of the model questions on history. So here, before you go to the examination, which is to be scheduled on the 4th of October, we have brought some here the important questions which can be here asked or here resembling that here type of questions can be asked in your examination. So, do watch it and prepare well for the examination. So, today we will take here the session here of the model questions. Just these questions might have been repeated in your previous exams, but as far as here my knowledge is concerned, here they have been not repeated, and they are the questions which you should also see to it when you go for the examinations. So here this is mainly the for UPSC aspirants. Here we start with the session. As it is mentioned here by most of the people who have attempted the UPSC questions, most questions will be on the modern Indian history. So, these 15 questions what you will be having are here on modern India. Exclusively on modern India, I have taken the questions, and try to here get the answer before I give you the answer. So, the first question, which statement or statements is or are correct in respect of 1833 Charter Act? So, Charter Act, you know that 1813, 1833, 1853, these three charter acts are very important. You can have questions on that. So, what are the statements given here? The company monopoly over trade with China and on tea continued. The slavery was abolished in India. Indian laws were to be codified and consolidated. No Indian citizen was to be denied employment under the company on the basis of religion, color, birth and descent. So, these are the statements. Now, the question is here whether only one statement is correct or two statements are correct or all are correct or only one is correct. Now, you have to see the here this 1833 Act. So, the first statement, if you look at the company monopoly over trade with China and on tea continued, this is wrong. As you know that 1813 Charter Act had abolished the monopoly of the company of the trade here, but it had continued here in on China, on tea and with China in 1833 Charter Act. But here we are given again in 1833 it was continued, it is given, this is a wrong statement. So, this is not correct. The slavery was abolished in India, as you know it, it is a 1843, the slavery was abolished. Indian laws were to be codified and consolidated. This is here a correct answer. 1833 Charter Act, you know that a law member was appointed, T.P. Macaulay was appointed as the law member. Thomas Babington Macaulay was appointed, and he was entrusted with this codification, and no Indian citizen was to be denied employment on the basis of religion, color, birth and descent. So, the third and fourth are correct answer. So, we have the answer B, that is 3 and 4 are correct. So, like this you have to analyze those statements. The second question, which statement is incorrect? Now, earlier question was correct. So, slightly you have to read the question very carefully, students. Incorrect with regard to 1919 Government of India Act, or popularly known as Montego Chelmsford reforms, 1919. So, the statements which is incorrect you have to find out. Separate electorates for Sikhs and Anglo-Indians was given. The act separated central and provincial, here mainly provincial budget. A High Commissioner for India was established at Delhi. The act mentioned of appointment of a commission a decade later to study the working of the act. Now, if you look at these statements, the first one is correct, second one is correct, and the third one, what you have seen, a high commissioner for India was here established at Delhi. No, it was not established at Delhi, it was established at London. And the first here high commissioner appointed was William Stevenson Mayer. This is a wrong statement in this. So that becomes the answer. C is the answer there. So you can look at a high commissioner for India was established at Delhi. That is a wrong answer. Which statement or statement is or are correct in respect of Ahom revolt of 1828? So this is on the topic of the socio-religious movements, where we have the peasant movements are, tribal movements are there, the religious movements are there, Muslim, Parsi. So we have got the different movements. So related to that, this question has come up. The Ahom revolt occurred in Bengal, the first statement. The leader of the movement, Gomdar Konwar, the revolt was against Bengal Zamindars. This is mainly what we have, the three statements, which one of them is correct. Now you look at the statements. The Ahom revolt occurred in Bengal. This is a wrong statement. This is a not a correct statement, because Ahoms are mainly concentrated in Punjab region, the Assam region. They have been concentrated in the Assam region. The leader of the movement was Gomdar Konwar. That is the right answer. The revolt was against Bengal Zamindars. No, it is a wrong. Again, because the here itself only we have given that it is Bengal. Bengal is wrong, because the answer is Assam there. So this is also a wrong statement. So actually this revolt was against the British, as it had been mainly promised after 1824, the first Burma Act, they will withdraw their military, but they were stationed there, and that was the cause for the movement there. The Britishers must withdraw from the Assam region. This is mainly, it is a wrong statement. So the only right statement is the second one is a right statement. Only second is correct. That is the answer. Which of the statement or statement is or true in relation with the settlement of Danes in India? So very rarely when we ask who are the Europeans who came to India, usually what the students will tell, the Portuguese, the Dutch, the British and the French. But they forget to tell here the fifth one, that is the Danes from Denmark. So after the British arrival, we have the Danes, then the French. So related to Danes settlement here, which of the statements are true? That we have to note it. The first factory of Danes in India was at Trankobar. This is a true statement. Trankobar was their first settlement. 1616, the Danes arrived in India. Trankobar comes in Tamil Nadu. Srirampur was the capital of the Danes in India. It is correct. Srirampur comes in Bengal. The Danes sold their factories in India to French and departed. The third statement is wrong. The third statement is wrong, because they sold in 1845 their settlements to the British. So not to the French, it is to the British. Only first two are correct. The first two here, 1 and 2 are correct there. So that you have the answer, 1 and 2 are correct. So like this, Danes here held one of the most important settlement in India. Their settlement was Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And that here went to Britishers after they sold in 1845. And the Andaman was established as the penal colony of the British, where Indian leaders were sent for the punishment. And in mainly that region, Andaman and Nicobar Island, we have that famous here, the cellular jail. At Andaman, we have got the cellular jail, where one of the great revolutionary of India, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, spent 10 years for that RI punishment, rigorous imprisonment punishment. It was at a cellular jail in Andaman there. That was purchased from the Danes by the British. match the newspapers with their editors during Indian national movement. So on a new type of question, that is on newspapers. So I have given listed in A side the papers, Sudharak, Hindustan, Vande Matram, Swaraj. On the other side, Madam Kama, Subhash Chandra Bose, Gopal Krishna Gokhale and G.P. Varani. These are what we have got, mainly the here the editors of this. Sudharak was mainly edited by, so we have mainly here the statements, Sudharak, Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Hindustan, we have G.P. Varani. Vande Matram, Madam Kama. And here Swaraj, Subhash Chandra Bose. So these were the editors, 3, 4, 1, 2. That is the right answer what we have got. Especially I would like to mention for the here the students, here Madam Kama, she has the honors of hoisting the tricolor flag on the foreign soil for the first time. So it was at Stuttgart in Germany, she hoisted the tricolor flag in 1907, and she has been called as the mother of Indian Revolution, Madam Kama, Bikaji Kama. That is, the answer is 3, 4, 1, 2. The next one, which statement is incorrect in respect of Second Carnatic War? Three Carnatic Wars were fought, popularly also known as Anglo-French Wars. Carnatic is the name of a place in South India in Tamil Nadu. And for the supremacy between the British and the French, these wars had taken place in the middle of the 18th century. And which of them is correct, that we have to, here mainly incorrect, we have to study that. The statements you look at, in the Battle of Ambur, Nawab of Karnataka, Chand Sahib was killed. This is the first statement what we have got. Robert Clive led the British Army in the Second Carnatic War. During Second Carnatic War, Dupleix was the French governor. With the end of the Second Carnatic War, Muhammad Ali became the Nawab of Karnataka. Now, which is incorrect to be identified? The first statement what we have, in the Battle of Ambur, that is Nawab of Karnataka, Chand Sahib. Here he was not killed. The Nawab of here mainly, here who was killed was Anwaruddin in the Battle of here Ambur. So it was not Chand Sahib. So this is a wrong statement what we have got. This is an incorrect statement. The rest of the three are correct. Robert Clive was leading the British Army and Dupleix was the French governor. And after the Second Carnatic War end, that was in 1754 when it ended, Muhammad Ali, with the support of the British, he had become the Nawab of Karnataka. That is the thing we had to know, that Battle of Ambur, Nawab, Karnataka, Chand Sahib was killed. That is a wrong answer, incorrect answer. Moving to the next one, the Mughal Emperor who was called Shah-e-Bekhabar. These are sometimes mainly here asked such questions, which are very direct. You have to remember, these are memory type of questions. You have to remember this. Here, the answer for this is Bahadur Shah first. Bahadur Shah first, here is called as, here, mainly the Shah-e-Bekhabar, the negligent. Now, who has made this statement? Another here thing to be remembered by the students. It was Aurangzeb's court historian, Kafi Khan, has made this here statement. Kafi Khan, Mantak Ub Lubab, that is the book written by Kafi Khan. Mantak Ul Lubab. In that, he has called here Bahadur Shah, whose early name was here Mauzum Shah, son of Aurangzeb. He was called as Shah-e-Bekhabar, the negligent. Like this, here Kafi Khan has made this statement here. So, this is just a memory question. Sometimes such questions will also appear in your examination. Deoband movement organized by Muslims of India, which statement is correct? Correct or incorrect? Why I am concentrating on these statements? Because UPSC will be asking more statements in your examinations. So each statement has to be properly read, understood, and then come to the conclusion. The object of Deoband movement was to propagate the teachings of Quran. As I have mentioned, it was a Muslim movement. Develop cordial relation with the British. Which of these two statements is correct? That has to be noted there. So, if you look at the first one, Deoband movement was a very orthodox movement, and they mainly wanted to propagate that here the Quran principles. Whereas, develop cordial relation, this is a wrong statement. So, only the first one is the correct. That is, only A is correct. That is, the first one is correct. The next one, after the stoppage of non-cooperation movement in 1922, which had been started by Mahatma Gandhiji, and with the incident of Chauri Chaura, February 5th, 1922, Gandhiji asked the movement to be stopped. In Congress emerged two groups called pro-changers and no-changers. Pro-changers and no-changers. Who among were the leaders of pro-changers? Now, just here in very few books, this information is available. Pro-changers were mainly those leaders who were against the Gandhian principle. They wanted a change. They did not want to continue with that, the non-violence principle of Gandhi. No-changers wanted to continue with Gandhi. So, pro-changers we have asked, and if you look at Babu Rajendra Prasad, Motilal Nehru, Vallabhbhai Patel, C.R. Das. So, who were mainly here pro-changers group? We have got Motilal Nehru and Chittaranjan Das. These two were from the pro-changers group. And later Chittaranjan Das, 1923, established that Swaraj Party. Swaraj Party was established by Chittaranjan Das, popularly called as Desha Bandhu. And later Subhash Chandra Bose recognized C.R. Das as his political teacher. These are some related information to the students. So, this Motilal Nehru and C.R. Das is the right answer what we have got, B and D. Then next, which of the statement or statements are true in respect of Jallianwala Bagh incident? So, the previous year, 2019, was celebrated as the centenary year of the tragic incident of Jallianwala Bagh at Amritsar, which took place on April 13, 1919, the massacre that took place. That is, here mainly on that incident, here statements are given. You can expect some questions also there. Which of the statements is correct? The Secretary of the State for India, Edwin Montagu, ordered a committee of inquiry to be appointed after the event. So, what is the event? You know it. I need not go into the details of that event. So, an inquiry will be appointed. A committee will be appointed for the inquiry. The committee was called as a Disorders Inquiry Committee. Disorders Inquiry Committee, the second statement. The committee was chaired by William Hunter. Now, these are the three statements. Which statements are mainly true to the incident of Jallianwala Bagh? Now, if you look at these three, all the three statements are correct. Now, sometimes such questions, here all the statements will be correct, and you have to say that all 1, 2, 3 are mainly correct there. Like this, the answers you have to find out there. So, that was here popularly known as here the Hunter Commission, which was appointed by here the British to inquire into the tragic incident of Jallianwala Bagh. And after this, we come across here Gandhiji was given the leadership, who and he made his mainly entry in the national movement, and by launching the non-cooperation movement and giving back his title given by the British government, Kaiser e Hind, returning back the title, he started the non-cooperation movement. That is the later history what we have got. That is the mainly the answer. Arrange the events in chronological order. Again, a memory question. It's a memory. You have to remember the events and try to here put it in a proper order, which is the first event occurred. Now, construction of the Fort William, transfer of Portuguese capital from Cochin to Goa, establishment of Adventurous Merchant Society of London, Farman of Mughal Emperor Farrukh Siyar called Magna Carta of Company. these are here are the four statements which are there. Now arrange them in a chronological order. Now which is the earliest one if you notice here? So the earliest one you can find is a transfer of the Portuguese capital from Goa, here from Kochi to Goa. That was in 1530. Nina do Coha transferred this capital. That was in 1530. This is the first you get. Then the establishment of the Adventurers Merchant Society of London, that was in 1599 at London, it was established, which later on came to be called as East India Company. Then we have the construction of the Fort William, 1697, and last one is the Ferman of Forroxyar, 1717. So that is how the order is there. First it will be 2, 3, then 1, 4. So the answer is the B there. That is what we have got the answer. So it is just a memory question, you have to remember it. The 12th one, statement on one of the personality of the 1857 revolt it is. Here lay the woman who was the only man among rebels who made this statement. So almost you have also seen a movie on that woman which has mainly come out, and in that also this statement has been taken there. In this mainly here to whom it is related, the question here, and who made this statement. The answers are Hugh Rose, Colin Campbell, John Nicholson, Colonel Neil, and the answer is Hugh Rose, and he makes this here statement here, paying the tribute from the bravery of the woman who fought against the British in 1857 revolt, that is Rani Lakshmi Bai. Rani Lakshmi Bai, here this is the related, and Hugh Rose was the person who has made that statement. Like this, here the questions, you have to know it. Which of the pairs is wrongly matched? Now, the pairs have been given, which is wrongly matched with the leaders and place in connections with the 1857 revolt. So, among this, which one is wrongly matched? So, on one side, we have the places where the 1857 revolt has taken place, and in another, here we have got the leaders who led that. So, this here, which is wrongly matched? Bareilly, Khan Bahadur, it is correct. Faizabad, Mauli Ahmadullah, that is also correct. Delhi, Bhakt Khan, it is correct. Jagdishpur, Ramachandra Pandurang, that is wrong. Ramachandra Pandurang was associated with Nana Saheb at Kanpur and later Lakshmi Bai there. And Ramachandra Pandurang is popularly known in history with his nickname, that is Tatya Topi. That is, he was associated mainly with Kanpur, Nana Saheb, where it was the leader. So, Jagdishpur, it was conversing. So, this is a wrongly matched pair there. That is the answer we have got wrongly matched. Who among the following participated in the all the three round table conferences? Very interesting question. All the three. Usually when we ask who was the person who called, the only answer it comes is about Ambedkar. We say Ambedkar. Now apart from Ambedkar, we have got here another two or three persons who have participated in all the three round table conferences. So who were they? Akbar Haidari, Tej Bahadur Sapru, Mirza Ismail and Muhammad Iqbal. So who among these? So the representations they have given, Hyderabad state, from the Liberal Party, from Mysore state and from Muslim League. Who participated in all the three round table conferences? So Akbar Haidari, Tej Bahadur Sapru, Mirza Ismail, remember they have participated in all the three round table conferences. Who among the following have participated in all the three round table conferences? But whereas Muhammad Iqbal from Muslim League has participated only in two. And the another one, you know that it was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who has participated in all the three round table conferences. So particularly from Mysore state, it was Mirza Ismail, the Diwan of Mysore, who has represented Mysore in all the three round table conferences. Hyderabad, Akbar Haidari, then we have Tej Bahadur Sapru from the Liberal Party. They have all participated in the all the three round table conferences. The last question. Komagato Maro incident enraged the members of a revolutionary association and they prepared for a revolution to end the British rule in India. The revolutionary association was. So this is a very popular incident which has taken place. Komagato Maru is a ship which had been hired to take here the 6, here 376 in number by Gurjit Singh. It was a Japanese ship he had hired to take them to Canada. But in Canada it was very humiliating here, the situation. They were not allowed to step in Canada and they had to come back. That is, they returned back there. This discrimination policy. And coming to India at Calcutta at a place called Baj Baj, there was a clash and there was a brutal here brutality of the British on the six who had went in that ship, Komagata Maru there. This here incident enraged one of the party and they planned for a revolution. This incident took place in 1914 and that party was Gadar Party in America, San Francisco. Gadar Party, which had been established in America, here San Francisco, and its center in India was Punjab. And Gadar Party members here planned for the revolution in 1915, February 20th, against the British to end the British rule in India. However, the precautionary measures of the British, the revolution did not take place. So the party associated is Gadar Party and the incident is Komagato Maru incident. It is the name of a Japanese ship. Like this, here, these are the statements what we have got here for your mainly the syllabus. Just all the questions I have taken it from the modern India. And there are a few sessions of mine where I have taken the questions from medieval India also and from ancient India also. That will be also put on the Classic Education YouTube. Do watch it before you go to your examination. I wish you all the best for your examination. Thank you.